Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. You have to guard your heart.
Yes.
We have to be careful with the way that we throw our heart around.
Yes. Yes.
We have to be careful in the way that we allow people to use us. And we have to be careful with boomerang love. A boomerang, if you know anything about the Aborigines or those who, yeah, that's just a 23 instead of 24. If you know anything about those folk in Australia, they have this this boomerang, a wooden instrument that is shaped kind of like a bean. They throw it and it comes back. They can throw it and it will loop back around and they can catch it. So throw it, catch it, throw it, catch it. And so it's boomerang. You throw it in order to get it back. And so what oftentimes happens is we have a boomerang kind of love. I throw it, Sister Moa, in order for you to throw it back to me. I'll only throw it to you if you'll throw it back to me. I'll only love you if you can love me. I only will give to you what you can give to me. And so there are a whole lot of folks who are always looking to get something anytime they give something. There are some folks that cannot freely give. They're always string attached to whatever they do. But in order for us to become like Christ, we have to learn how to give love and let that love just be there without expecting anything back. Because what happens when we expect something back is we actually leave our heart open for hurt. Because the moment that our expectation is not met, Sister Jackie Turner, then we're hurt. I called you, you should call me back. I took you to dinner, you should do this for me. And so we end up on that roller coaster because the very time you meet somebody like myself, and you know my great philosophy. That's why you're laughing, because everybody knows I'm not. But at least I'm honest with you, I tell you up front. What is my response to a favor?
Thank you.
Thank you. As somebody knows. My response to a favor is thank you. And so to keep you from being hurt, I'll tell you up front that my response is thank you. Other than that, I don't feel any bounds to any kind of contract that's going to hold my heart in your captivity. So if you do something for me, I will simply say thank you. When I do something for you, all I expect is thank you. If we can learn how to give in that way, it causes us to be healthier because we're no longer expecting for somebody to do in response to what we do. That would actually solve half of our problem, probably more than that. We wouldn't be as angry at our children when we feel like they owe us something, we raise them. And in a sense, they do. We wouldn't be as angry with our spouses, we wouldn't be as angry with our church, our job, and so on and so forth, because they really owe you nothing. Aside from that, if we stop expecting that, aside from that, we must understand that Christ has actually told us, and maybe some of you think that, oh, well, that's very harsh, that Christ thinks that the world is like that. Christ told us that the world is like that. He told us that on the broad way that leads to destruction, there are many. And on the narrow way, the way that leads to righteousness, that way there's just a few. So actually, Christ told us, Sister Devonna Johnson, up front, that there were going to be more shiesty, nasty, mean, non-reciprocal, non-giving, I'll take from you and drain you kind of people in the world than loving, caring, kind of people. He already told us. And so if we understand that, then our expectation will not be that someone will always give us because we're giving them. My expectation will allow me not to get involved with everybody on an intimate level. And I'm not just talking about men and women. I mean on an intimate level whereby I give you my heart and trust you with it. So you know my next statement here. One is I say thank you. Two, I don't trust you. I don't trust you. I don't trust not one member of this congregation, including my wife. I don't trust you. You've heard me say that before. I don't trust you. But I do trust God. That's the only place that my trust needs to be. Because when I trust God, even on my wife's worst day, when she feels like that she needs to do something with my money that she shouldn't, God will step in. If we trust God, I shared this with, and you know me, I'm transparent, I shared this with the Bible study the other week. I was saying that there was a woman that was coming through my life. And I said to my wife, I thought this woman, there was something wrong. Remember I said, I thought there was something wrong. I thought she was trying to get closer than she should. Now, I wasn't attracted to her, but that's why I noticed her. And so I wanted to step back. But I didn't even have to let her move. Because before I knew it, the Lord had put forth a series of events that took her all the way out of my life. And I said, thank you, Lord. If we trust God, God will do what we need Him to do. If we trust God, He will take care of our situation. If we trust Him and we love Him and we're willing to be submissive to Him. If we stop trusting everybody and anybody with our heart, if we stop expecting anybody to do anything for us other than God, and we put our focus in the right place, and we guard our heart, meaning that my heart belongs to God, and as my heart belongs to God, I can only do with my heart what my Father says do. And so my Father wants me to love Him with all my heart, mind, and soul. So everything belongs to Him. And then He tells me to love my neighbor as myself. Not to love them as they do to me. Not to love them because they'll get back to me. Not to love them because I have an expectation of them. But to love them because He's my Father. And so my focus has to be on Him. My trust, my love, my heart. Guard your heart. There's a lot going on in the church, and there's a lot of folks who cannot focus on what God wants them to do because their heart is in so many other places. I watch y'all going off on Facebook. Yeah, I watch you, and sometimes I have to just FMH. Just shaking my head. Because I can't believe some of the roller coasters that folks are going on emotionally. And not only are you going on these emotional roller coasters, but you're making them go. So let everybody look at it. I'm thinking there's somebody that's just using you and watching you. Every day you wake up, they tell you when to go to bed. They tell you when to eat. They tell you when not to eat. They tell you when to be depressed. They tell you when you can't sleep. They tell you when to be up 2 o'clock in the morning. Screw it over. They tell you when to go looking for a rebound relationship. So we're giving our hearts away to everybody. And not only are we giving our hearts away to everybody, we're showing our vulnerability to everybody. Because if I were a man on the cross, I see you, Brother Carroll. You're laughing, but you know I'm telling the truth for you. If I were a man on the cross, I'd be on Facebook. Because I know when you're mad. I know when you're mad at your father. I know when you're by yourself. I'm lonely tonight. You go on down, I'm going to see. And we're on that roller coaster, just giving our hearts away. And letting people know that we're vulnerable. Letting people know that we're vulnerable. Letting people know that we're hurting. And letting people know. And that is the relationship that needs to take place on God's book and not on Facebook. You don't give your heart away like that. You have to guard your heart. Your heart has to belong to God. If we don't guard our heart, then we'll allow all kinds of predators to come and give us spiritual heart attacks. 24, verse 24. Put away from thee a froward mouth, and perverse lips put far from thee. You need to watch your mouth. You need to watch your mouth. Some of us talk way too much. And then some of us that don't talk too much, we just hate for talking. And some folks, you just wish they would just stop. It's just always either negative or something is wrong. And they pronounce death in their own lives. There's always something wrong. But there's always a problem. There's always some sad situation that's coming. You hate to see them come. Because their mouth is always running. Some folks just talk nasty all the time. And you can see their heart from their lips because they're always talking crazy. They're sick because the waitress keeps spitting in their food. Because they won't close their mouth. You cuss everybody out, and I guarantee you that over time you're going to have some issues. It causes issues at work because your mouth is running. It causes issues in your home because you're just talking too much. And always something. We got to start learning how to close our mouths. Some of our issues even with God. You haven't heard God. Well, why is it? God, why are you not speaking to me? God, I just want to get an understanding what's going on in my life. God, why me? God, I just don't know why you allowed me to do this in my life. God, are you going to answer me? Please answer me, God. Because you really ask. God didn't answer me at all. I just started talking to God, and God didn't answer. It's because you won't shut up long enough for God to respond. Sometimes it's the same thing with husbands and wives. If the other person would just shut up long enough for the other person, just take it in. But sometimes one person is just talking so much, and I'm not talking about Mr. Kelly. I'm not talking about Mr. Kelly. But I do know, I've watched situations where a spouse just talks so much to the other spouse can't even think or get a word in edgewise. I was at a restaurant about 3 weeks ago, and I was sitting beside some folks. And there was a woman who talked, and they were so fine, I think two of them got up and went to the bathroom. I was like, well, I guess they're going to have a conversation. And the one that was left, she just kept on talking. And for that whole entire meal, that woman just talked straight to that old man. Don't take a statement. Sometimes the issue with us is that we won't close our mouth. Now, let me give you one other point here. If you are dealing with relationships, whether it be boyfriend, girlfriend, whether it be just friends, shut up long enough for them to tell you I'm crazy.
That's right.
See, sometimes the reason that you didn't find out that they were crazy until after you have been with them for a really long time is because you've been doing all the talking. If you would shut up, you'd find out that that's a fool you've been with. We gotta learn how to close our mouths and not talk so much. If you stop gossiping and close your mouth long enough, somebody might tell you what they're saying about you.